Okay, here we are with another Google Drive tutorial. This time I'm going to talk to you about how you can integrate a Google Drive document into your website. It's one of the powerful things about the Google tools is that they work very seamlessly together. So I am looking right now at my library. I just noticed a couple icons over here that are worth mentioning. This little eye is for this pane right here, so you can toggle that in and out. You can see different activity. I open this item here, calendar survey. Josh has opened up the intramurals. That was yesterday at 1 o'clock. You can see these are documents that are shared with you and the activity on them, the recent activity. There's a couple different views here. If you don't like that, you can toggle that off. There's a couple different views here. This is for your library right now, and this is my preference. I like to look at it in a list form. You can also look at it in an icon form like this. So in a list form, I would say the benefit is that you could sort by title. It's usually sorted by the last modified date, so whatever is modified or changed most recently pops up to the top. One thing about Drive that I don't really like all that much is the organization. So you can create folders, as I said, but they're all kind of bunched up in this library. The good news is that obviously Google is a search engine, so their search engine function is really, really good. So if you're looking for a folder or a file, all you have to do is type in the a keyword here and look it up. So let me show you what we're gonna do today. I have an iKind messages page. And at Crocker, we announce these iKind messages on the HTV News, which I run. And I have a schedule, which is a Google spreadsheet right here. So I have embedded this Google spreadsheet within my website. So the neat thing about that is that I can change this Google spreadsheet, and any changes that I make automatically update on my website. So I don't even have to go to my website to change it. All I have to do is to change the this Google spreadsheet, and it will update on the website. Anyways, let's go and check it out. Over here, I can type in my keyword here, and there it is. So this is the spreadsheet that I've made. It basically just has some columns, has the date. It has refers to the topic and the content that we're pulling from. I have my students write out the script from this information. I've blocked out the weekend dates here. So that is created in with the spreadsheet in Drive. And then let me show you how to embed a Google document into your website. So let's go down here to some of my test pages. And I have a page called Google Doc Test. Now, as you know, you have your icons up here to edit this page. I click on this. And so under Insert, there's a menu called Insert. You can insert a whole bunch of different things. And obviously, we have an item for Drive. Under Drive, you have, it's kind of a pull-down menu. You have a whole bunch of different options. You can insert any of these things here. So we want this spreadsheet, and it will refer to the spreadsheets that I have in my library. So all I have to do is pick out the iKind spreadsheet. Let me find it here. There it is, right there. So I'm going to click on that. I'm going to select it. Now this comes up. You can include a border around the spreadsheet if you want it. You can include a title. You can adjust the height or width, and you can view it as a spreadsheet. So it's up to you. You can mess around with this and see how they look, but this basically comes in And you don't see it in this edit mode. It just kind of is a box right here. And you can see when you click on it, you have some different options. This first icon, the gears, is this properties page that you just were at. This is your justification. You can left align, which it is right now. You can center it on the page, or you can right justify. So centered is probably pretty good. It also has an option for text wrapping to wrap text around an item that you have. And then if you want to delete the embedded item, you can just press X right here, and that will delete this whole spreadsheet. And then once you save it, you can go and check out how it looks. And there it is. So it's as easy as that. It's very simple to embed. Again, all you have to do is edit your page, go into Insert, select the drive and the type of file that you want from your Google Drive, and click Save, and it will embed it in there like that. So you can embed, obviously, any kind of Google Drive document. Let's see, I have another one embedded under job descriptions right here for my HTV news jobs. This is just a Google document that's embedded in onto this web page. So I can go and share this out on my web page, and I can edit it in Google Docs, and all of the edits will come up live here on my website. So this is a really cool thing. Google has a bunch of tools. They work really well together. And you know, it's a really easy way to keep your website up to date by creating a calendar or something in Google Docs that you can update, and it will show up on your website. Blah, 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 blah.